There shall be a battle and terrible carnage before the God of Israel. For that shall be the day appointed from ancient times for the battle of destruction of the sons of darkness. Cursed be Satan for his sinful purpose, and may he be destroyed for his wicked rule. Cursed be all the spirits of his company for their ungodly purpose. Truly they are the sons of darkness.
I would like you to open your copies of The Poisonous Mushroom. Helmet, will you read first?
A devil goes to the land. The Jew he is, known to us all as murderer of the people and polluter of the races. The terror of children in every country.
Helga, your turn. Stand up, please.
From a Jew's face, the wicked devil speaks to us. The devil who in every country is known as the evil plague. Would we from the Jew be free, then be gay and happy? Then must you fight with us to get rid of the Jewish devil.
We'll be right back. wasn't he there? When did it all happen? Why did he let it happen?
If a God can allow things like that to happen, then either there is no God, or even if there is, who needs him?
Baby! Yeah.
In ancient Mesopotamia, drought, famine, and disease were all seen as the angry face of the gods, just as rich harvests and replenishing rains showed their favor. The world started as chaos, and for the ancient Mesopotamians, there was always the risk that it would revert to its original state.
A battle broke out between the old primeval gods of chaos and the good gods who'd been created. And the primeval deities created an army to help them. And these are the composite creatures. These are things made out of birds and lions and scorpions and bulls and so on. And this happens before man is created. So you've got an intermediate phase of creation when these hybrids are formed. And they fight on the side of evil to start with. But then when they seem subdued, they become the servants of the good gods. They become the servants of the good gods. They become the servants of the good gods. They become the servants of
the evil force that the Egyptians identified in humanity was represented by the god Seth. Initially, he was worshipped as a necessary part of the cosmos. On this ancient papyrus fragment, Seth is depicted for the last time as a force for good. Seth, as god of the foreign, became so strongly linked with the Persian invaders who came from the desert hills that the desert itself became the lair of the evil spirit. Seth had become something purely evil, something to be feared, the true ancestor of the devil.
The Near East civilization was seen as a battle against the encroaching power of the desert, which could constantly wipe out and threaten all human achievement. When people imagine the death of a city, as the prophets of Israel do, they see the city reverting to the desert, going back to extinction, symbolic extinction.
This is Megiddo, by the Jezreel Plain, an ancient stronghold between East and West, known in the Bible as Armageddon. It is the setting of Satan's final showdown with the armies of God. It is Israel's most ancient battleground. The Israelites were defeated here in the 7th century BC, and ever since the name of Armageddon conjures up the final conflict between the forces of good and evil.
After the Battle of Armageddon, when the Antichrist and his servants are defeated, their blood will flow down here and go down to the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea is considered to be the opening of the gates of hell, according to the Book of Revelation. You'll see all of the pollution which has come from the poison of the devil and the Antichrist will end up in the same place.
The devil was born in the desert. The character most clearly depicted in the Book of Revelation has haunted our imaginations ever since, waiting to devour those sinners who have transgressed God's laws, and providing the explanation for life's misfortunes and disasters. And providing the explanation for life's misfortunes and disaster.